It's pathetic. So we don't have water for years. And we just keep on talking, and simply people are just not, it's not a big priority. Priority is just getting bills. It's not right.
The proposal was made by Diana Atwine, the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Health, while appearing alongside officials from National Water and Sewage Corporation before Parliament's Health Committee. That was discussing the issue of unpaid water bills, which has seen some hospitals' water cut off over failure to pay their bills.
Now in Mulago, we don't have water. They rationalize. They switch off, they switch on. Their water is flickering in, then it's not coming. We have had many meetings with the National Water. It is not about protection of our mandates and our offices and our positions. It is about provision of services. That's why we expect everyone to understand that life, it is life, it has no spare. When we are serving, we must dedicate. Even we must dedicate resources, we must dedicate time, we must dedicate technical input.
Talking about is water for cleaning the floors. It is water for the toilets, you know. We're not talking about water for the injectables. We're not talking about drinking water. There should be a provision to facilitate, to allow them to drill these boreholes. But in the event that they don't even meet the water quality, I'm aware that in Kampala there are drug manufacturing facilities that have boreholes with water treatment facilities that are producing water that matches the same quality as National Water. So this is something that we need strong commitment from you.
Atwine's remarks followed a revelation by Johnson Amayo, the Deputy Managing Director, Technical Services, that of 31st January 2024, ministries, departments and agencies of government had unpaid water bills amounting to 14.993 billion shillings, with some of the bills having remained unpaid for over 2 years.
Those are sick regarding funding. They need to be helped.
Atwine informed the committee that the Minister of Health held several meetings with the Minister of Finance in which the teams agreed to budget for water harvesting facilities in order to reduce on the cost of water. But some sections in the Water Act limit the construction of boreholes in urban areas for fears that the water would be contaminated.
What is it more important than life? Tell me, can someone tell me here? What is more important than life? Factories, we need them for development, yes. Cities, we need them, yes. But what is more important than having dedicated lines and available and stable?
However, Amayo denied existence of such a policy that bars the construction of boreholes in urban areas, but warned the Minister of Health that such a move would expose Kampala and surrounding areas to unmanageable cholera outbreaks.
But keep in mind the issue of quality. You're addressing one problem, but you can create another problem. Your hospital is turning into centers of infection.
China, Friendship Naguru Hospital. Then we have Chirudu and Kawempe, both plumbing and sewage. And these hospitals are less than 10 years old, so they have burst pipes.
The National Water and Sewage Corporation informed Parliament that among the health facilities with high unpaid water bills include Mulago National Referral Hospital, whose bill stands at 3.73 billion shillings, Jinja Regional Referral Hospital at 3.656 billion shillings, Mulago Specialized Women Hospital at 2.11 billion shillings, and Naguru Hospital at 1.48 billion shillings.
Amayo says they should pay the bills, and indeed they need to pay the bills, because if they do not pay the bills, we are crippling the Ministry of Water.
The average date age for hospitals is 10 months, with most regional referral hospitals having a date age of over 12 months. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.